So welcome everyone to Mini Ignite, our first session here. Thanks for joining us. We've got several people that showed up as we are doing these throughout the day. We didn't know what kind of participation we would have. So glad to see at least a few of you chose to come to Flipgrid. For those of you that may not know me, my name's Matt Brandenberger. I'm one of the technology coordinators with FWCS. I am over the elementary area along with Sarah Scheip and Shannon Quigley. And I'm joined this morning by
Steve Armstrong.
Needs no introduction.
No introduction. Thank you, Matt.
Steve is also a district technology coordinator, but he does a whole lot of other stuff too. He's the man when it comes to videos, DJing, you need something, audio, video. Steve's a man. He's got his Mountain Dew and he's ready to go. So he's going to be manning the chat.
If you asked Terry, green slips. I've got a lot of green slips. So green sometimes slip. Those are worth jeans days in schools.
Ooh, okay. Yeah. We all love jeans days for sure. So today we are talking about Flipgrid. During this first hour session, we'll probably try to get you out of here a little bit early so that you can go find your second PL of the day. If you have not seen the list, can give you access to that at the end. Maybe just put that in the chat and Steve could put the link there if you're needing that. But if you found us, you probably have found that as well. So Flipgrid is what we're talking about. As people were trickling in, I just kind of asked for everyone to give me kind of a fist of five. I see some threes, a 0/1. So we've got some newbies, which I kind of figured. So this is going to be a fairly basic kind of get to know session with Flipgrid, but maybe show you a couple things as well that you haven't seen. Want this to be interactive though. So please chime in if you have used Flipgrid or if there's a feature that I miss or something you really want to highlight, feel free to drop that in the chat or even with only having, you know, eight or so of us in here, I don't mind if you unmute and want to ask a question. I do kind of want to move through this presentation in a way that kind of shows you some stuff and then gives you the chance to kind of do some hands-on time as well. So we'll kind of be bouncing back between, you know, kind of an I do and then you do type session. So to get started, first of all, we need to know how to access Flipgrid and how to log in. So you can get to Flipgrid simply by going to flipgrid.com. I do think there is a link in Clever. So if you're, you know, just have Clever up and you want to click on that, that's fine. I would probably suggest just having like a link in your toolbar at the top. But to get there, you just go to flipgrid.com. For students, a lot of people ask, like, you know, sending students to Flipgrid. Really, we'll learn this a little bit later, but it's really more about giving them the link to your group or to your topic that you've put out there in Flipgrid. So they don't really need to have like a Clever link or anything like that. You're gonna be giving them either through the LMS or however you share links and whatnot, you're gonna be giving that to them, the specific URL that takes them to your page more or less, either your group that might have multiple topics in it or a specific topic that you're wanting to share with them. So I'm at flipgrid.com. If you click the login button, I'm probably already logged in through our single sign-on. If you have not logged in before, it may take you to like a Google page. So let me just log out so that you can see what that looks like, and then we'll give all of you the chance to do that. So if I'm logged out and I go to flipgrid.com and then click log in, it will take me and it'll say, what do you want to use? I'm going to choose my Google login. And then we're just going to use our FWCS credentials. You can see I have a personal Gmail account as well, but I do not want to use my personal account. I'm going to use my FWCS account, which is also a Google account. I click that, log in successful, and it's going to bring up kind of our dashboard, our main page in Flipgrid.
So if we really need to get a hold of you, Matt, we can connect with you on that personal Gmail account.
Absolutely. Yep.
That's okay. Thank you.
Yep. You can send those pictures and videos you like to send me, Steve. They're maybe not appropriate for school. I mean, like those memes and stuff. So yes, send them there. We don't want to get in trouble, Steve. All right. So once you're there, here's your dashboard. You've got what it takes you to this main page here that says discussion. I do want to give you just a minute or two to make sure that you're here with me. So Take a minute, log in again by going to flipgrid.com. If you need any help, unmute your mic and we'll help you along, but let's get everybody to this page here. Take a minute and get there. For those of you who may not be familiar with the Alt tab, is a great way to switch back and forth between applications on your laptops. So if you have me up in one Zoom window and you hit Alt tab and kind of hold down on that, you can go back and forth between a Chrome window and the Zoom. So you can kind of flip back and forth. That's an easy way to do it. Great little tip if you don't know it. I use that all the time. All right, I think hopefully most of you are there. Again, put some in the chat, or if you need help, you can unmute yourself and let us know. But again, just kind of looking at this dashboard or your homepage of Flipgrid, if you want to call it that, across the top, you have discussion, which is the default that it goes to. We'll talk about some of these others a little bit later. But under discussion, this is kind of what Flipgrid was built for. So they've added some other things since Flipgrid started, but kind of think of it like a virtual video-based discussion board. So instead of just having text, you can actually put in videos and add fun things, actually all kinds of media, not just videos. It could be a text or things like that that you want to have a discussion about. So it's a great way to encourage student engagement. Kids love not only to see themselves, but to see their classmates, to see you on video. And we'll talk about that a little bit later as well. But I would highly encourage you, if you have not tried Flipgrid in your classroom, it's a great tool to use throughout the year. Anytime you're kind of wanting to have a virtual discussion and want to put things out there, it's all about giving students voice and choice. And Flipgrid's a great way for maybe some of your reluctant students who may not want to raise their hand in front of their classmates, but they would feel more comfortable recording themselves on video. There are students like that. Flipgrid's a great way to do that. So as I kind of flip back and forth between my presentation, we've talked about accessing and logging in. The next thing we want to do is talk about how to add a group. So the group, think about a group. If I have my elementary folks out there, I would almost think about a group being like a subject area. So you could have a different Flipgrid group for every subject area. So you can see my groups, since I'm, you know, at the district level, I don't have these divided up by subject areas. I have them, you know, kind of by different things that we have done, maybe throughout, like we did a TechMas one, and there's some stuff there. I'm working on kind of a beginning of the year 20-day plan. And so that's my fourth and fifth grade ones you see here. But as an elementary teacher, you know, you could have a group for each individual subject, you know, a language arts or math Flipgrid that you would want to divide those up. For secondary, you might be thinking in terms of units of study. So for every unit, you'd have a different one, or maybe you divide them up by quarters, quarter one Flipgrid. So those are kind of, think of it like the big basket. It has, you know, lots, it's going to have lots of different topics in it, but this is just kind of the group that we have. So I have eight groups set up. You see the tab then that you can look at topics within the group. So if I look at, here's all of my topics, and then it says which group it is in. If I go into my groups at the top, then you can see like this Mr. B's grid that I played around with before has seven different topics that are within it as well. And each of these are almost like an assignment or an individual, you know, thread of videos or discussions that are going on. So let me go back to, if you just click on Flipgrid at the top, that'll kind of take you back to that homepage, or I could have clicked on discussion as well. First thing I want to do with you though is learn how to create a group. So I'm going to create a group here by clicking the button at the top that says create a group. And then it's going to come up with these details. So you can change the cover image if you want. If you click on this, you can find a whole bunch of preloaded, you know, pictures that you may want to do. I'll just leave this as it is right now. I don't know exactly what I'm looking at, but it's colorful, pretty. And we'll just call this Mini Ignite Flipgrid. So that's the name of my group. And for now, you can kind of just watch this. I will give you some time to work and create your own as well. Group status, you can choose it as active or hidden. If you're choosing hidden, then that would be if you're just kind of wanting to set it up, but not have people access it yet. Under the permissions, this is very important for how you're setting this up as a teacher. You're going to give your students access, and what you're going to choose is student email. So this is going to then give you the option to enter the domains that will be accepted into your group. So you want to have for sure your students group, which would be at fwcsstudents.org. So you'd put that in, and then if you put a comma, and then I think it's a comma. Yep. I just tabbed out of it and went back into it. But I think if you separate them by comma, I would also put at fwcs.k12, .in.us. That way, if any other teachers or anybody else in the district that you wanted to be a part of this would try to join your page, it's going to allow them. If you don't do this, their students are going to be denied when they try to have access to your page. That's very important to do. And then at the bottom here, you see it says notifications. You can choose however you want to get notifications. I would not recommend daily, but maybe put weekly updates. I kind of like to do that, just have an update there. If it's something I'm engaged in, I'm checking on it already, I don't really need the notifications. And then you can choose group notifications for others, allow people to get an email notification for new responses and comments. Leave that on. If people want to have those, then they can. So creating a group is fairly easy, just those couple things to do. Go ahead and do the same. I'm going to create a group, and you'll see that it says your group is ready, and it gives a specific URL that you can then share out with your students. And possibly a little bit later, if we have some time, I might have you share yours out to have other people in this PL engage in your group as well. So take the time here to just create a group. Again, going through those steps from the main page there, you're going to click on the create a group, and then you're going to fill out this information. You can call it whatever you would like. Maybe you want to set one up that your students are actually going to use. You could call it beginning of the year or whatever it might be. And then under the student email, I'll go ahead and put these two back in here so you can see those. That's fwcsstudents.org and at fwcs.k12.in.us. And yep, separating those with a comma does work. So go ahead and take 2 minutes and set up your group, and then we'll be back with you then. Any questions, unmute or drop a note in the chat. I can probably put a little music on for you, a little elevator music or something. This has gotten me in trouble before, though, Steve, so I don't really know lyrics.
I may have to take over if it crashes or something.
Can't go wrong with the Lumineers, so I'll just go with some Lumineers here. Just another minute or so. All right, let's go ahead and move on here. Question for you though, as you've kind of, as you're creating these groups, interested to know what kind of groups were created. So maybe drop something in the chat here real quick. Tell me what group you created, or more importantly, I guess, how you would see for whatever position you're in, kind of dividing these up. I kind of gave the couple suggestions that I would say, but either unmute yourself or drop in the chat. I want to hear from at least a couple of you what how you would divide up groups, you think, in Flipgrid. How about one person, just one? One person, tell me what would be a group? How would you divide these up? There's one coming across. Thanks, Deb. Set mine up for seventh grade science classes. Okay, good. And so then maybe as a seventh grade science teacher, you'd have a different one for each one, or you could have one big one and have kids that are in different science classes be able to interact with each other, even though they're not technically in the same class together like that. Okay, Jamie, thanks. Is an intervention I divide up by grade level. Yeah, that's good. And Sarah responding to a prompt to check for understanding with ELA. Okay, that would be kind of like an individual topic then that you would do. So your group that you set up would just be, you know, either ELA or math. And then as we get into topics, that's a great idea there for responding to a prompt, check for understanding sort of thing. All right, very good. So let's move on to our next section, which would be creating topics. So now that we have the group is kind of the big bucket, and now we can put topics within that group. So here again is what that looks like. If I go back to my Mr. B's grid here, this is my group, and then within my group I have several topics. So if I was seventh grade science then, and I had a group for each one of my classes, then these would then have the different activities. So think of a topic kind of like an activity that you're doing. So if you're doing something on an area and perimeter, then you'd have that this activity here. So let's learn how we can create that topic. I'll go to the one that I just created for our mini Ignite group. And when I click on it, then I can see kind of the overview of what our topic looks like right now, or I'm sorry, what our group looks like. Right now I have zero topics. So I want to create a topic. And to do that, I'm going to create a topic by clicking on this button here that says create a topic. Pretty self-explanatory. And then once I do that, it's going to pull up this screen here, and I'll kind of scroll down to see there's not too much stuff to fill out here. So we want to give it a title. So let's just say this title will say favorite summer memory. 2021. Okay. So if we have time and we kind of interact on these together, then you would be able to respond to my topic that I created here. Favorite summer memory 21 is the title. You can see the prompt. It does have an asterisk, which I believe means it is required. So you don't have to put much here because you're going to see in a second that it's a good idea to put some video down here as well. So I'll just kind of write a quick little question here. What was your favorite memory from this summer? There's explanatory. Put that in there is my prompt. You have 1,000 characters to do, so you can, you know, write a little bit longer thing if you want. And then it gives you the option to add media. This is not mandatory to do, but as I said earlier, students really love to see what you do, what teachers modeling, you know, putting video in. And so sometimes I know it's a lot of teachers feel like they don't like to see themselves on camera, or they feel kind of silly, but I would encourage you, this is a more and more important thing for students to feel comfortable in front of a device, when they're, thinking about jobs, in the future. That's, it's a big thing to be able to present yourself well on camera. And so it's good to try to model that as best you can. So there are several different types of media that you can choose across the board here. The most common one, and that's why it's the first one, is the recording of a video. And so we'll look at that here in a little bit. I want to talk a little bit more about the permissions though. Guest password, you can put a password on if you want, but I don't think that's really necessary if you're handing students the link to this. You don't really need to have them go the extra step of putting a password on there. Topic moderation, only video responses and comments that you've approved will be shared. Again, this is up to teacher discretion. I talked to some teachers who, struggle with having students put inappropriate things. So this is a nice feature to have if you want to be able to moderate those. Other people would say, I don't have the time to go through every single response. You know, we're going to teach good classroom, appropriate online behavior. And if somebody violates that, then we'll deal with the consequences there. So that's kind of the way I would lean, in all honesty, unless somebody does something to violate that. I'm going to, trust that my students know how to appropriately reply to this sort of things. Recording time. This is really important here. If I do the drop down here, you can see that you could do as short as a 15 second response. So this can be good if you just want them to do like a real quick response. I highly suggest not doing anything more than even a minute, unless it's something where they're doing a presentation and you're wanting them to give, several minutes. But the last thing you want to do is set this to 10 minutes and then have students that are just rambling on for something that they should have just done in 1 minute. And, Steve is a big video creator, and I think statistics would show that it's like 2 to 3 minutes is kind of the time. Anytime you have a video much longer than that, you're losing the attention span. Unfortunately, that's where we're at in this country with our attention spans, but it is what it is, and we want to try our best to keep our students engaged. So comments, again, you can allow comments on video responses. You could do video and text comments, just video, just text, or none at all. We'll leave it as video and text. And then closed captions is automatically done and does a pretty good job. It's not perfect. There's sometimes where it says something or hear something differently than you were trying to say, but the closed caption does work pretty well, which is really nice, especially for hearing impaired students. So those are kind of the essentials. Again, I want to give you a couple minutes to create your own topic. Again, if you want to do one just for fun, or if you're kind of thinking beginning of the school year already, this could be kind of, you could do a similar thing with your students, kind of a back to school one of asking what was their favorite memory that they did, or tell me something about you that that you want me to know, type of thing. So go ahead and create your own topic, or if you have something else you would like to do, I'll give you a couple minutes and then we'll be back with you to finish this. Just leave it where we have it right now. So don't hit the create topic yet. Just fill out the things that we had talked about here. I'll give you just a minute or two.
Hey, Matt, I'm new to the Lumineers as of today.
Are you really?
So do you have a recommendation on what album to start with?
I'm not. I just have a playlist for on my Apple Music. I just like to do a little randomness. So I can't give you any strong recommendations on albums.
I'll have to check them out.
Yeah. When you left this town, your windows down. if you get done and we're waiting for other people, go ahead and drop in the chat what a good topic idea would be. Maybe share out what you did or what you think would be something you'd do this year with your students. All right. Anybody have anything they'd stick in the chat or unmute yourselves? Topic ideas, share with others. Maybe it spurs on an idea for somebody else. Like a couple people to share out there or finish up your topic. Give you a second to do that. I guess I'm looking here at the chat. I do see Kimberly. It said, I use it for whole class discussion on any topic. Keep it basic. Could be for fourth grade class or the entire fourth grade. Good. And yeah, that's where it can be shared kind of across other classes as well. And is a nice opportunity for kids to be able to interact with other students in the school that they may not sit in a classroom with. So, all right, we'll move on to video creation. Oh, wait, one more popped in the chat. Deb, I have kids tell me what they believe spontaneous generation is. Follow-up is trying to grow maggots. Spontaneous generation, yes or no? Okay, good stuff. Good intro there. I love it. Okay, so the last part of this in creating a topic, and the reason I had you not quite create or finish the topic by clicking the create button is we want to add some media. So we're going to click on this red button here, and this will bring up the camera within Flipgrid. And what it's going to allow you to do is record up to 10 minutes. And again, we talked about wanting to keep these kind of quick, but this is a way to kind of introduce your topic and tell your students what you're going to want them to be doing. And I just want to kind of highlight some of the options and effects that are down here at the bottom. So the circle is the record button. So when we're ready to record, we'll hit that. But if I click on options, there's a few different things here where you can turn just the mic on so that you don't want to show your face, or you can mirror the video. This is really nice because sometimes if you've like tried to show something and you hold it up, it's like backwards. So like if I was trying to teach something and this is like backwards, I can hit the mirror image and then it's the right way. So that's kind of a nice feature there. And then mute button, then you can't hear me. You can record your screen, and this is somewhat new to Flipgrid. So you can actually like record your screen and do kind of like a screencastify type video if you want to show your students instructions or show them where to go or that sort of thing. And then there's some other device settings that are on here as well. So the options are on the left side here where you can kind of change some of that stuff around. And then on the right side is effects. You've got different filters where you can kind of change the the tone of it and what it looks like. You can even like pixelate it and make it look kind of funky. Here's my pixelated self, little rainbow colors, or you can go back to no filter at all. Other filter or other things that you have here for effects is you can add text. I've got some different options in terms of adding text there. It's nice. You can do like a whiteboard type thing. So you have like the ink feature so you could draw on the screen. I like to kind of combine that effect with what is called the board. So you have the board up here. And let's say that I have this dot grid, I'm doing math. What's really cool about Flipgrid is that you can change how much of the screen. So if I just want myself to be off on the side here, but I want this board here and I want to kind of demonstrate almost like a Khan Academy type video, I can, you know, draw over here on my whiteboard as students see my face up here as well. So that's kind of a cool feature there. Again, if you're on the board, you can change how much of the screen is showing. So there's just like line paper, a notebook type thing. You've got some other options as well, regular line paper. Those are the board features. Stickers, you've just got fun emoji type stickers that you can put on there as well. If you want to upload a photo, you can click and drag a photo in and put it into your video as well. So when you're ready to record, then for this one, I'm going to clear the board by hitting that. And I'm just going to, I'll leave this up here since I already have it up. I'm just going to go ahead and record. And remember, my topic was on summer memories. So give me a little countdown. Hello, students. It's Mr. B. And I am just excited to hear about what you did this summer that you were most excited about. So tell me one memory that you had from this summer, something that you did with your family, something that you accomplished that you were really hoping to do, and tell me all about your favorite summer memory. So then I can pause it when I'm done, and then I'm going to hit the next button. Hello, students. I never loved the way you sound on video. I'll hit next again. I do have the options to kind of trim this up. So if I wanted to kind of change part of it, I think I can trim that.
Hello, students. Oh, yeah, it's Mr. B.
So these blue lines on the end, if you wanted to cut off the beginning because you didn't start right away, or you didn't hit the end button soon enough, you can kind of trim that up if you want. Once you're done, you can say confirm.
Hello, student.
And then if you wanted to add more, so if you forgot to say something, you can hit the add more button. But if you like what you have and you're ready to move on, you'll hit the next. And then it says confirm your cover photo. So this is kind of what they will see there. I don't love my cover photo. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to choose to take a selfie for my cover photo. And then this is where you can kind of have some fun with this. Again, you have the effects that you can put on. So I'm going to go in the effects to the stickers and I'll just do my little shaded guy there. I click that sticker and then I can change the size of it. Then I can make a little emoji sticker, right? Crazy hair on top, and then hit the capture button. And so then that's my cover photo. Could even add text to it as well. If you wanted to put like favorite summer memory or something like that, you could add some more effects there as well. But when you're ready, hit confirm. Now it says confirm your cover photo. I like that. We'll use that. So I'm going to say confirm. It's going to upload my video, which was what, about 30 seconds long, if that, 20 seconds, I think. So it says success. At any time, you can delete or redo the topic video from the settings page. Good little thing to know there. And then I'm going to hit done. And now it has added that media into my new topic that I created. So I have my title, I have my prompt that I put in, and now I have my video and all the settings that we talked about here. Now I'm ready to hit that blue button to create the topic. Okay. Now each group, if you remember, had its own URL, but now every topic has its own unique URL as well. So if you wanted your students, if your students got used to going to your Flipgrid group and you just told them to go there and go to the summer video or summer memory topic, then they could go there. But if you wanted them to go specifically to this URL, this would take them directly to that topic on their favorite summer memory. So it's nice to have that as well. And I can show you where to get that besides here as well. But if you just finished this, then you would copy it and then you could take it over to the LMS, drop the link in there so all your students could go directly to your topic. Hit all set. And now we can see if I go into my Flipgrid and into my Mini Ignite Flipgrid group, I have one topic that was created. If I click on that group, you can see the one here so far has zero responses. What I'd like you to do now is take a couple minutes and go ahead and finish creating your topic by adding your video in. Just kind of talk through what your topic is. Again, I'll just give you a couple minutes to record that and then we'll go on to the next. Just another minute or so to finish up creating your video. If you have any questions about that or can't find something that you saw me do, let me know. Let's reshow it. All right, something else to point out here is we're coming back. You see on my topic here where it has this option, or this is my group, my Mini Ignite Flipgrid group. I can add a co-pilot. So if I have a co-teacher or another, you know, fourth grade teacher that I teach with and I want to invite them, I can put their email in here as well. And then they can be a co-pilot on my group so we can kind of share that group as well. So that's kind of a nice feature that I didn't point out a little earlier. So let's do this then. I want to talk about sharing. So from the student perspective, I did see something pop up in chat here. Once we are done, do you want us to hit the create topic? Yes, please, Jamie, go ahead, and anybody else, you can hit the create topic button and you are good to go. Then you can get back to your group and see your topic in there. So let's pretend you're my students and you are, and I want to share this out with you. I didn't write down or I didn't copy the topic there. I can go back into my group and I can see this topic here and I want to share it with you. So if I go to the three dots right here, actually the little share button is right there. It's not under the three dots. It's to share this topic. If I click on that, it's going to bring up the exact same screen here. And I've got this URL then that you can join this. So if I say copy, it's going to copy that to my clipboard. And then I'm just going to drop it in the chat here. And we'd love for at least a couple of you to go to my topic there and respond to it with your favorite memory. This will kind of lead us then into the last part that I want to show you how, what it looks like when you have students respond and how they can respond to each other. So take that link from the chat, record a response with your favorite summer memory. Doesn't have to be more than 15 to 30 seconds, somewhere in there, telling about what your favorite memory was, recording in the same way that, you did there to create your topic. But now you are responding to my topic. So again, it was that easy just to get the link, share it out. You could do that through the LMS. You could do that through whatever means you have of sharing things with your students. Probably most commonly will be through Schoology. So take a couple minutes and I'll be able to kind of see the responses as, they come in, and then be able to kind of move on to that last part of responding to each other's as a teacher and students responding to other students.
And Matt, had you in the beginning not added .fwcsk12in, I wouldn't have been able to reply, right?
Correct. Yep.
Great. So that's why if you're doing this for staff or something, it's good to add that domain.
Yep. Absolutely.
Gotcha.
Yep. Not sure if these will just show up in real time or if I'll have to kind of refresh my page here, but right now it shows zero responses.
I've been trying to do it right. I've been living a lonely life. I've been sleeping.
All right, Terry, you're the winner. You're the first one in there. Way to go. Thank you. So you can see here, I refreshed the page and it showed that Terry has responded. Give another minute to hopefully have a couple other people finish up, and we'll
I'm amazed at how fast it uploads that video.
Yeah, I agree with you. I don't think it's like HD or anything, but still it's
No, but you have effects and different things like that. That takes time and right. Move pretty well.
Yeah. Awesome. Steve's got his in there too. Beautiful. So we got at least three of you, a couple more come in as well. That's fine. So then from my standpoint as the teacher, I see this topic that we have here, and I see the responses that have come in. So I can click on the individual ones and I can see Steve's come across. I don't know if is the sound going to show up. It may not show up for me since I have my other sound on, but Steve, the video looks, you look good for sure. So then I can go back to the topic there and see all of them, or you see this little video shows me, I think this was Jamie's was next. So I can click on Jamie's And hers comes up.
My favorite summer memory was being able to actually leave the state and go visit family. We have a lot of family that lives in New England, whereas where my husband and I are originally from. Nice. We actually got to go and see them after a whole year plus of not.
Very good. So nice job. So maybe Steve might have something wrong. You did mention you have some sound issues sometimes as well. So your sound didn't come through. But
well, and when I clicked on it, I'm recording this session in Zoom. I'm the host of this. So that might have played something inside of that. But very jealous man of New England. That's amazing.
Yeah. The only problem is I'm guessing they might be Patriot fans. That I mean, maybe is that right? I don't know. I'm sorry if they are, but I guess maybe we don't have the rivalry there. Uh-oh. Yes, she says they are Patriot fans. I'm sorry to hear that. That's all right. We'll hold that against you. And then Terry's video came across as well. Nice job.
Good morning. This is Terry Seitz from Harrison Hill. And my favorite memory was going to Nashville with my college friends. Love it. Was good to get together with them and listen to some great music.
Awesome. I've heard Nashville. I've not been to Nashville in years, but I've heard it's just the place to go. So that's awesome. So yeah, I've had some more come in then as well. So then what you can do from your perspective, you're probably seeing this, and I don't really have a good way to show from the student perspective, but you're able to see each other since I put those settings that you can respond to each other's as well. So if I did want to go in and maybe tell Steve that his sound wasn't working, then it was kind of hidden as I was showing the video. But if you scroll down here, you have some options then to either share it out. You could share this with other people, or you could add a public comment, or you could record a comment as well. So you could kind of respond back and forth and start a dialogue then, just kind of like a message board where you have like a thread of different things. So you have options to respond, you know, me as a teacher, or as students, you guys should be able to see each other's as well. And maybe, Steve, can you confirm that? What does it look like on your end?
What's the question there?
Do you see all the other comments that your fellow students have made to this board as well?
Yes. Yeah.
So you're able to kind of go through those also. And again, that's Matt, a setting that can change, yeah.
Can you give a non-public comment back there to me as the student?
I believe so. As a teacher, okay. Then I think I can go in and I can change this. So add a comment. I have either
public nice.
Or private. I have the drop down.
Okay. Right there. Cool. Long.
Yep. Good question. All right. So really that we're kind of up against the clock here. That was mostly what I wanted to show. I want to make sure that I answer any questions that you have. But the last thing that I was going to show, if I go up to Flipgrid here, we spent all of our time in discussion. There are some other things across the top here. The discovery, there's topics that are generated. The one I would highlight is this Wonderopolis is an awesome website, and they have a wonder of the day. So every day they have like a topic that's just created for you. So even if you didn't want to create your own, you could come in here to the discovery portion is where I'm at. And you could find this wonder of the day. You click on it, and then you can add that topic to your class, and you could share it out. You can, again, make it for just your class to kind of participate, or with students from literally all over the world. So really kind of cool, all the stuff that they have built into there. You can play around under discovery. You can also go to the activity portion. This just shows you like your activity or students that are a part of your topics or grids that they can view what has been done. Mixtapes is kind of like just your own library to save different things that you've done. But the one that I really would want to highlight to you is shorts. So instead of using like a Screencastify or some other sort of video recording app, you can just come in here. You don't even have to use the discussion. If you had a video that you wanted to record, you can do that. And here's what's really cool about this. In the old LMS that we used, we were able to, and I'm sure there's a way to do this in Schoology as well. But if I click on one of these that I recorded, You have a way to share this just by simply getting the embed code. So you could copy the link and that's fine, but getting this embed code, you could take this video and just in a couple quick clicks, you click on this and then you take it over to Schoology and you choose the embed option. You're able to just put that video so it shows up right there on your Schoology page. So it's a great tool to use that video recording. I don't know why they call them shorts, just like a short video, but you have again up to like 10 minutes of record time that you could record your video and put it right into the LMS very easily. So that's probably my favorite extra feature that Flipgrid offers. Any other questions? Or Steve, did you see anything in the chat? I'm just clicking on that as well.
Could I share that on a Class Dojo for a topic prior to school starting? How would I change the emails? So I think, Terry, you saying change the email domain back at the beginning. Yeah. You probably want to add one to it.
Yeah, and there are other ways. So let me go back to this. When I go into create a group, if you remember, there were these three different options, student email, student username, or class, Google Classroom. We don't use Google Classroom, but I'm just wondering if you added students individually, students with a username. So you might be able to like upload all of those students in and then share the group with them. You could have them access it that way. Once you have a group created, because I'm just trying to think like of all the, it'd be hard to add every domain. I guess you could look, if you had a list of all of the different types of email addresses, you could add all of those domains. Like a lot of them are probably Gmail or Yahoo or things like that. But some parents might have like a work email that's individual. But if you added all those domains, they would be able to access it. Would be another way. But each group does have a join code. So you could give them this join code. But I think they have to either have the correct domain or you have to have added them manually kind of under that username one. Have to play with that. That's a good question, Terry. Not 100% sure on it. Any other questions or anything to cover? Hopefully this was at the very least a good refresher of Flipgrid and maybe gets you thinking about how you could use it this school year. Flipgrid's one of those things that's very versatile. There's so much you could do. I mean, in any subject area with any topic, it's just a great thing. I mean, it kind of can be a last minute thing like, hey, let's do a Flipgrid on this. Tell me what your thoughts are. You know, students have access to technology at home. It can be even a good thing for them to be able to do away from school as well. All right, with that, we will wrap it up. We're 5 minutes away from our next one, so I better run to get to my next spot. But thanks for joining us. Steve, is there an exit slip or anything we're supposed to drop in the chat? I don't even know.
I don't think so on this one.
Okay, then we're good.
If not, I took a screenshot of the group, so I will send it to you.
There you go.
I'm sure Shipey will yell at us later.
I know. We'll get in trouble. Get our slap.
But thank you. We appreciate you all coming in on this summer day.
Absolutely. Definitely you guys do. Have a great day. Talk to you soon.